Hello, welcome back. So we have already discussed the four stages of press history. Now we will move on to the origin of newspapers in India. So you can add these things into the four stages also. So this is just a detailed description of what happened in all these stages and which were the important newspapers of that stage, of that particular stages. Okay, so we will start. So the origin of newspapers in India. So origin of newspapers. Printing presses were brought to India by Christian missionaries for publishing evangelical literature. So I have already mentioned that. And publications include the Bible and other aids to conversion and evangelization. The first printed book in India was Doctrina Christi in 1557. It was printed at a printing press by Jesuit priests. It was a catechism book written by Saint Francis Xavier. And the second printing press was established in 1578 at Punnikkal, Tamil Nadu. This too was a missionary initiative. And the Tamil Directory was published in 1679. Then East India Company also set up printing press in different parts of the country to aid efficient administration of the subcontinent. So the birth of the newspaper was towards the end of 18th century. Okay. So first we will start with James Augustus Hickey, the most important name in the history of printing press and Indian journalism. Okay. So I told you the press originated in India during the British rule. The major players were British citizens, and Hickey brought the first newspaper to India, and that was in the year 1780 in Calcutta. Okay, so Bengal Gazette was the name of the newspaper. It is also known as Calcutta Gentle Advertiser, and it was a weekly newspaper in English. Its front page carried only classify ads. Just imagine, that time in 1780, it carried classified ads. Okay, so I told you James Augustus Hickey had the distinction of launching the first newspaper in India, that is Bengal Gazette. It is in 1780, and it is also known as Calcutta General Advertiser. Okay. And Hickey was the founder, promoter, and editor of this weekly. Told you this was a weekly newspaper. It had two pages, and its size was 12 by 18 inches. It contained news of the fighting between East India Company and the local kings. Okay, so very interesting news, especially during that time. And other news items the reports of the parties hosted by the British residents in Calcutta, advertisement notices of property, articles for sale, and there was a column, Hickey's column. He wrote about British rule and and Indian people. Then there was a poet corner, then letters to the editor. So Hickey is considered as a pioneer in journalism. Okay, and he had to stop the press, his press, in the year 1782, because actually he wrote against the British people also. So obviously he had to shut down his press. Okay, another important personality is William Bowles. If you see, you cannot find his name in most of the journalism books. I don't know why. The first attempt to start a newspaper in Calcutta was made by William Bowles, actually. But he is not considered as the first, the founder of this thing. But he had a newspaper. Actually, he offered a newspaper to his fellow countrymen in Calcutta. But Bengal Gazette is considered as the first newspaper in India. And, Hickey is the person behind it, and this is just for your information. William Bowles, that was he is also are part of this Indian journalism or the history of Indian journalism. He also had a newspaper, okay? And next is Serampore Missionary. I told you, like, the missionaries actually brought so many changes to our countries, English education, and also Christianity, and also, like, you know, dissemination of news and all that stuff. Okay, so Serampore missionaries, a group of missionaries, they are very important. So a group of Baptist missionaries from England who settled down in Serampore, Bengal. So it is founded by Dr. William Carey and Dr. Joshua Marshman and William Ward. So the credit of starting the first vernacular newspaper goes to Serampore missionaries. Okay. As I told you, what is a vernacular newspaper? Because this is a regional newspaper, okay? So their publications included Digdarshan, Digdarshan, and Samachar Darpan, and the Friend of India. So this is a very important question. You always get questions like, you know, the contributions of Serampore missionaries to Indian press. So this is very important part of the history of Indian press, okay? So Digdarshan, if you talk about Digdarshan started in 1818, a monthly magazine in Bengali, and carried reports on political activities, reports on history and all. Then you have Samachar Darpan. The name Digdarshan was changed into Samachar Darpan in 1819, and it was 1 rupee per month, and became a bilingual weekly because it had English as well as Bengali articles. And the Friend of India is a complete English magazine, started on 30th April 1818, and Joshua Marshin was the editor. And he published essays on subjects related to India and this particular newspaper. And objectives were to aid conversion to Christianity and to support the views of the British administrators in India. So Serampore missionaries, obviously they supported. They wanted, obviously, the converted, like, they wanted to convert the people, and also they supported the British administrators in India. So next important personality. So we have already covered James Augustus Hickey, William Ward, Serampore missionaries, group of missionaries. Then James Silk Buckingham, another important champion in the history of Indian press. Okay. An outstanding figure among the pioneers of the press of India. Jawaharlal Nehru described him as the earliest champions of the freedom of press in India. So one of the most controversial personality in Indian journalism, he made his appearance in 1818 as the editor of Calcutta Journal. So that is his publication's name. Again, back to Calcutta Journal. So, you know, this James Buckingham actually supported Indians. That's why he had to, you know, shut down his press. Okay. So Calcutta Journal was started by some British merchants in Calcutta to propagate their views and protect their interests. First issue on October 2nd, 1818. 8-page bi-weekly newspaper priced at rupees 1. So the content included political, commercials, literary, news and views. Okay. Buckingham is a different man. Okay, he considered press to be a necessity in the absence of a legislature. So when there is no legislature, you have to have something called a press. And he laid emphasis on news of local condition, the life of the people, and the critical reports on the company. So the Readers' Forum, a notable feature, was open to express the inefficiencies of the British rule. Okay, so there was a column called Readers Forum, and that forum, even we have forums now, like, you know, where you can discuss your questions, your queries, or, you know, if you have any, you know, opinion, we can discuss that. So that time he had, in 1818, he had this idea of having a forum in his newspaper. Just imagine, like, you know, what a visionary he was. And according to him, the editor's function was to admonish governors of their duties, to warn them furiously on their faults and to tell disagreeable truth. Okay, I told you, like, he was a very good journalist, because he actually followed the journalistic practices. And by 1822, Calcutta Journal had increased its circulation and gained wide popularity. So he was bold and impartial in his writings, not like the other people. He was very impartial in his writing. So of course, you know, what would have been happened, like, you know, the British authorities became intolerant in account of his persistent criticism on their policies. And in 1823, John Adam, the acting governor general, deported Buckingham to England. So in the same year, he started a newspaper in England named Oriental Herald. And there he actually, published news articles related to this atrocities against Indian people by the British. So just imagine, like, you know, his passion for journalism. So Ram Mohan Roy, we have already discussed stage one. So Ram Mohan Roy. So Nehru described Ram Mohan Roy as the father of Indian journalism. So if you refer any books, you cannot see one particular person as the father of Indian journalism, because there were so many pioneers, so many titans in Indian journalism. So you just cannot call one person as the father of Indian journalism. But Nehru described Rajaram Mohan Roy as the father of Indian journalism. He called James Silk Buckingham as the champion. Okay. And Roy sponsored many journals, edited them, fought for social reforms, and defended criticism leveled against Vedanta philosophy by the Christian missionaries. So he used to disseminate information related to Hinduism and all that stuff. And excuse me, one of his famous philosophy was Vedanta. And you know, this British people, they started writing against this Vedanta philosophy. And of course, through his publications, he answered all the questions raised by these British. He was born in 1772 in an aristocratic Bengali family. He mastered Persian, Arabic, Sanskrit, and English. Serampore missionaries' publications were bringing out offensive articles against Vedanta philosophy. So to counter the allegations and to propagate his progressive idea, he became a publisher and editor. To tackle those things, he became an editor. Okay. So the following newspapers were published by Roy at various times. So the first one was Sambhut Kaumudi. It was a Bengali weekly. We have already discussed this thing. And he campaigned against Sadi in this particular journal. And next is Miratul Akbar. That was the second journal. And 1921, he started this publication. And it was a weekly in Persian and published on every Friday. And it devoted a space for national and international news. His writings, obviously, I told you, like, there was something called a vernacular act imposed, enforced by the British. And his writings actually irritated the government, and that had led to the enactment of, this thing called John Adams' Vernacular Press Act of 1823. So, according to this act, okay, every newspaper had to obtain a license from the head of the government under the signature of the chief secretary. The official could cancel the license when they found matters tending to bring the government or on to hatred and contempt. So that was the gist of John Adams' Vernacular Press Act. So next was the Brahminical Magazine. So Brahminical Magazines, again an English monthly, to counter the missionaries' propaganda against Vedantic philosophy. The editor was Shiva Prasad Sharma, a friend of Roy. So 12 issues of these magazines appeared, later a regular periodical in English and Bengali titled Brahmin Sevadi was started by Roy. So these publications actually marked the real beginning of Indian journalism. So the others, we saw other people also. So they were British and they started papers here. But Rajaram Mohan Roy, Indian, being an Indian, he started newspapers. here in India. So that actually marked, you can say, the real beginning of Indian journalism. That's why Jawaharlal Nehru called him as the father of Indian journalism. And Ram Mohan used his journals to appeal to his countrymen to free themselves from superstitious beliefs. I told you people were like, that time especially, they believed, they had this superstitious belief, so many superstitious beliefs. And he actually wrote a lot against all these things. Okay. And he's also a social and religious reformer. He's known as a social and religious reformer. He propagated, he promoted English education and also founded Brahmo Samaj. Freedom movement and press. Okay, the pioneering work of Rajaram Mohan Roy led to the gradual growth of newspapers and magazines. Indian National Congress and other citizen associations were shaping Indian public opinion against the British. So Alan Octavian Hume founded INC, that is Indian National Congress, in 1885. INC was responsible for freeing the country from British imperialism. Okay, so the first session of INC in Bombay was attended by the founders and editors of all leading newspapers. As I told you before, most of these newspapers worked along with these national readers in the freedom struggle. And press coverage by the Nationalist Daily of the first INC marked, it was a great thing. Like, you know, so it actually gave a different coverage to actually this INC's first meeting than the Anglo-Indian press. Okay. And post-1857 period witnessed more strict regulation by the British government, especially for the vernacular press. During the last quarter of 19th century, nationalist press movement expanded phenomenally. Bal Gangadhar Tilak started two weeklies in 1880, Kesari in Marathi and Maratha in English. So other nationalist journalist was Gopal Krishna Gokhale. And, only newspaper took extreme step for advocating total freedom for the country. And World War I and the press in India. So what happened during that time? So the World War I had its repercussions in India as well. So after the declaration of the war, an order was issued by the government of India taking control of the press. So that was another thing happened during the World War I. So next important thing in the history of journalism is the emergence of Mahatma Gandhi. You can see Mahatma Gandhi as a freedom fighter, Mahatma Gandhi as a journalist. Okay, so M.K. Gandhi emerged as an important leader of the freedom movement in the post-war period. His leadership gave a new direction to national struggle. He edited three publications, Young India, Navjeevan and Harijan. Okay, and through these newspapers, he propagated the ideas of non-violence and satyagraha, and also non-cooperation movement. And during Jallianwala Bagh massacre, the national press expressed itself in a very strong language and criticized the atrocity. So press censorship was imposed. So you can see that whenever the media raises a question, against the British, they imposed some sort of censorship or rule on this media. The government of India, the Indian Press Ordinance of 1930, in order to control the press, the ordinance was passed to prevent the nationalist press from covering the Dandi March in 1930. The newspapers were asked to deposit huge securities whenever the authorities made a demand. Punishment for more serious offenses was the confiscation of the press itself. So more regional and English newspapers began in various parts of the country declaring support to the national movement. And you can see that throughout this period, most of these newspapers, they supported Indian National Congress and the freedom struggle. Next is news agencies during that time, during this pre-independent era. So Reuters, you know what is a news agency, of course. News agency is also called a wire service or a news service and all. So news agency is an organization which distributes news to different newspaper organizations. So in India, PTI is the largest news agency, and you have Reuters, that is an international agency. Then you have AFP, that is Agency France Presse. Then you have Associated Press, and you have Xinhua News Agency of China. And here we have PTI, UNI, Trust of India, Union News of India, and all. Okay. So if you check, you'll get more information of about news agencies. So news agencies usually they. Distribute or they give this news, this news, sorry, information to the different news paper organizations or television channels or radio channels and all. Okay, so Reuters was the only news agency that provided world news to Indian newspapers and periodicals. So KC Roy started an Indian news agency called Associated Press of India, but it couldn't function for a long on account of the stiff competitions from Reuters. So Roy was forced to amalgamate API with Reuters. So many of the nationals felt that British-controlled organization would never reflect the Congress point accurately. So the man who translated these ideas into a reality was S. Sadanandan, who had served some years with Reuters. So Free Press of India came into existence in 1927. So next important thing is Quit India Movement. So British authority made effort to control the nationalist press during the Quit India Movement launched by INC in 1942. So pro-Congress newspapers were Hindustan Times, edited by Devdas Gandhi, and National Herald, edited by Nehru. So Gandhiji suspended the publication of Harijan and other weeklies on account of pre-censorship imposed by the government. Next is transition to independence. So British-owned newspapers began to change ownership into Indian hands. So that is another important thing in the history of Indian journalism. So the Times of India was sold to Ramakrishna Dalmia. The Madras Mail came under Indian management. The Statesman came under the Tatas. So you can say that the saga of Indian freedom movement is synonymous with the history of Indian press. You cannot, segregate it. You cannot actually split it because both are the same. So national consciousness was aroused, sustained, and promoted by the newspaper. Now, press after independence. I already mentioned you a few points related to that. And with independence, the former leaders of the freedom struggle became the new rulers of the country. So that is the change, okay? And for the press, it marked a change in the role. Of course, they were actually supporting the INC before. Now they have to, obviously, they have to talk against the newspaper because, again, so they have become a view papers. Okay, and there were no serious exposed by the press during Nehru's period. Miss Gandhi was the next prominent political figure. And national emergency, the darkest period, it is known as the darkest period for the Indian democracy and the press. So on June 25th, 1975, Miss Gandhi declared emergency, and it lasted for 19 months. And so the press actually, actually helped, Jawaharlal Nehru in his administration, and but when actually Miss Gandhi, when she became the prime minister, the total scenario has changed. So the emergency, okay, when she declared emergency, the same day, okay, same day government issued a central censorship order and guidelines for the press. It addressed to all printers, publishers, editors, prohibited the publications of news, comments, rumors, and other reports relating to the actions taken by the government in accordance with the proclamation of emergency. So no newspapers were supposed to comment or publish any news related to this emergency, proclamation of emergency. And during this period, many journalists were jailed, Newspaper offices were raided and power supply was cut, and also they confiscated the press as well. The two newspapers which attempted to stand up to the government's repressive tactics were the Indian Express and the Statesman. Next is role of Mahatma Gandhi as a journalist. Okay, this is very important. Okay, so Mahatma Gandhi is a great champion of non-violent struggles, great journalist and promoter of newspaper, and his newspapers provided great moral support and sense of direction to non-violent freedom struggle against British. The British government passed the infamous Press Act of 1910, which imposed a number of restrictions on the press, and Gandhi's publications. We have already covered that. Young India, Harijan, Navjeevan. So he propagated his ideas through that. And Indian Opinion was a weekly published in four languages during 1903 to 1915 in South Africa. So when he was in South Africa, he published a newspaper that was called Indian Opinion. And this weekly drew attention of the authorities to the legal and political disabilities suffered by the Indian community in South Africa. And those days, Gandhi had the faith in the fairness of the British system and never advocated disloyalty to the British monarch. When Gandhi returned from South Africa and he began his political activities in India, and he started two newspapers, that is Young India and Harijan, and Young India's Gujarati edition is called the Navjeevan. And his journals carried articles on varieties of subjects written by him, ranging from the spinning wheel to the most important political problems of the day. And among the publications of Gandhiji, Harijan was the most important one because it had a great reach and became the Bible of the Congress and the masses led by Gandhi. Okay. And Harijan was published in Hindi, Gujarati under the name Harijan Bendu and Harijan Sevak respectively. The weeklies published by him had a deep impact on the country. He allowed other newspapers to carry his carry his articles. The views expressed by him in his weeklies always made an impact on the government. He also urged the newspapers to be free and frank in expressing their views and opinions. And the editorial topics of Gandhiji's publications were mainly focused on Hindu, Muslim unity, prohibition, promotion of khadi, and village industries, evils of untouchability, non-violence, women's education, village sanitation, and village industries. So, according to Gandhiji, so I told you he is a perfect journalist and and also a freedom fighter. Okay, and according to Gandhiji, a newspaper had three objectives to serve in a society. First one is to understand the popular feelings and give expressions to them. So you should understand what people need of the day. Then you act accordingly. Second one, to arouse among the people certain desirable sentiments. Third one, fearlessly expose popular defects that we lack these days, our newspapers lack these days. Okay. And his publications carried no advertisements. This enabled him to be totally independent in expressing his views. So that is the problem with today's newspapers. They give importance to advertisements than their news or views. Okay. So sometimes you have to be neutral with advertisers as well as the public. So these newspapers solely depended on the subscription from readers. Now it's, in today's scenario, it is very difficult to, run a newspaper with just subscription charges, because you give a very, meager amount for this. You get a very meager amount for this as subscription charges, because you rely mostly on advertisements from this huge, business entities. So the major difference between Gandhiji and the modern day journalist is that he considered journalism primarily as a service to the society and a vehicle for his views on religion, ethics, morality, politics, and economics. So you know what today's, I don't have to tell you, you know, what is today's journalist's perspective or their, you know, outlook on this journalism. Then Gandhiji wrote his autobiography, "The Sole Aim of Journalism Should Be a Service." So he wrote it and he mentioned this, the same thing in his autobiography as well. Like, you know, the sole aim of journalism should be service. It's not a business. It's a service. Okay. And growth of the Indian press in the post-independence era, you can see that Indian press includes 41 centenarians. Okay. 41 publications, they, you know, completed 100 years of service. Okay. The Gujarati Daily Mumbai Samachar, published from Mumbai, is the oldest surviving newspaper. As of 31st March 2006, there were 62,483 registered newspapers and on Registrar of Newspaper for India record. So if you check RNI, that is Registrar of Newspaper of India, So if you check their website, you can say as of today, how many newspapers are registered with them. Okay. And 1,05,443 print media as on December 2015. And the publishers under Section 19D of the PRB Act have to submit their annual statement to RNI. So we will come to that soon. You have to study all those things. So with this, we have come to the end of this particular particular session, that is history of newspaper in India. So I'll give you printed notes. I mean, yeah, probably like PDF copies of the notes. This is just a gist of your the entire session. So probably you can go through the notes, study materials, and you can ask questions in the forums. So thank you so much for your time. Thank you.